بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم. My dear students, welcome again to your general English language class. And I hope that you're enjoying your time during your first year. For today, actually, we are going to cover some reading skills like scanning, skimming, previewing vocabulary, and we will revise some of the grammars and structures that we have taken the first class. And hopefully that you are doing your homeworks. And then we have a writing center. We will having something about jumbled sentences. Okay, so we will cover هنغطي في هذه المحاضرة خمس أشياء: scanning, skimming, previewing vocabulary, revising, حراجة أيضا, some structures and grammars, and we have something called jumbled sentences. Okay. Scanning is a technique you often use when looking up a word in the telephone book or dictionary. You search for keywords or ideas. In most cases, you know that you are looking for. You know what you are looking for. So you are concentrating on finding a particular answer. Scanning involves moving your eyes quickly down the pages, seeking specific words and phrases. هذا معنى scanning. Once you read, you look at the lines so quickly. So you're moving your eyes so quickly down to the page. تطلع أو تقرأ بشكل سريع. Okay, فبتجعل عينيك بتحركوا بشكل سريع. هذا بنسميه scanning. حتى نهاية الصفحة. هذا بنسميه scanning. The scanning is used to organize, to find something about numbers, letters, steps, or words, or dates, or italics, or different, you know. So, in scanning is used to find something about numbers, letters, dates. So, in one passage, for example, like this one, let us do kind of a scanning here. خلينا نطبق السكانينج على هذا المثال. Without reading, بدون ما نقرأ, خلينا نطلع, just look at the question. The question is, how many species of Salamone have become extinct in BC? الإجابات هنا, the answers are numbers. شو مالهم؟ أرقام. So, shall I read the whole passage? هل من اللازم إني أقرأ كل الفقرة؟ لا. You need to look for the numbers and you need to look for something about the species of Salamon, لأنه هو سؤاله عن species of Salamon. الآن رقم 27, 27. You can find it here. الآن احنا نستخدم scanning. For example, number 27. 27. Okay, so it's not there. 31, it's right here. But 31 here is talking about the hectares. It is not talking about species of Salamon. So 27 is wrong, 31 is wrong, because the 31 right here is talking about the hectares. Okay, but the question is talking about species of Salamon. طيب, نشوف 137. هنا 137. لكن it is talking about species of a plant. Then it is wrong. We have 142. It's right here. Oh, it's talking now about species of Salamon. بتحكي عن ايش؟ Species of Salamon. إذن number D is correct. So this is what we call scanning. مثل ما شفتوا أنا ما قرأت أي شيء من القطعة ولا شيء، فقط اطلعت على السؤال وعلى الانسرز الإجابات، فوجدت أن كل هذه الأرقام ما إلها صلة في Species of Salamons، فبعمل عليها Elimination شط X. أوكي، لكن لما وجدت 142 is related إلها علاقة وضعتها هي الإجابة الصحيحة. طيب خلينا نعمل مثال ثاني على scanning. So today we have a scanning skill. لازم إيش تنتبهوا وتعملوا نفس الخطوات اللي بعملها أنا. لاحظوا الآن I'm not going to read the paragraph. مش حقرأ هذه الparagraph. I'm heading to read the question. The question is how much of the words in newsprint paper is supplied by Canada. مرة ثانية ما بقرأ كامل القطعة، بطلع وين الإجابات، بشوف النسب الآن. For example, this is هذه النسبة الأولى 31%. Then I go to the paragraph and read quickly. Move your eyes quickly. Okay. هل هي موجودة؟ No. Then this is wrong. It's not existed. It is not there. طيب بروح على الثانية 49. أها I found it. 49. هل ال 49 شو بتحكي؟ Of it's in newsprint paper. Then 49 is correct. See? بمسك الإجابات. You should read it or scan it one by one. One by one. Okay, 31 is not existed. 49 is related. متعلقة بالwords and use of print paper. مثل ما هذه الجملة موجودة. لو لاحظتوا الآن لو رحنا مثلا 34 لو كانت إجابتكم 34 هذه 34 بس عن شو بتحكي؟ عن الwood. وهذه إذن إجابة خاطئة. ال 19% it is not here. ما إلها علاقة. إذن X X صح X. هذه العملية this process is called scanning. This is one skill. The second skill is how to understand pronoun reference. Because you know the pronoun reference الضمائر مثل محمد الضمير المناسب إله هو he. Okay محمد باخذ هي اوكي بينما ماري تاخذ شي هذه بنسميها pronoun ضمير هي refers to محمد شي refers to ماري هذه معناها reference بمعنى الضمير بيرجع لأي اسم. Because a pronoun refers to a noun or takes the place of that noun, you have to use the correct pronoun so that your reader clearly understands which noun your pronoun is referring to. عشان نعرف انه هذا البرونون لشو بيرجع في هناك بعض الخطوات اللي لازم نتعلمها عن البرونون ريفرنس. الخطوة الأولى انه pronouns الضمائر should agree in number. يعني if the pronoun takes the place of a singular noun you have to use a singular pronoun. مثل محمد is singular مفرد he أيضا singular إذن he بترجع لمحمد إذن محمد واحد وهي واحد فهي ترجع لمحمد. For example, look at this example now. نطلع هذا المثال. If a student parks a car on campus, he or she has to buy a parking sticker. هذه جملة. if a student parks a car on campus, he or she has to buy a parking sticker. الآن أنا شو بدي أسألك؟ The question is, do we have a pronoun عندنا ضمائر؟ الجواب should be yes. اللي هي he or she. He or she refers to whom? To one people. بس لواحد، لشخص واحد. One person. طيب الآن what shall we do? We look at this sentence and we look on singular noun. Singular noun في هذه الجمل كانت a student, a car, or campus. He or she بترجع للعاقل البشر human beings. Campus حرم جامعي. It's not a human being. So it is incorrect. A car is not a human being. مش بشر. بينما student is a human being. It is a human being. والطالب ممكن يكون he or she. So the pronoun he or she agrees in number with the student. One student أخذ he and she. لاحظوا الآن في الجملة في الأسفل. If a student parks a car on campus, right here, they have to buy a parking sticker. The same sentence. لكن وين الاختلاف, the difference? بدل he or she كتبنا they. Is this sentence correct? هل هذه الجملة صحيحة? No, it's not. ليه? Campus قلنا غير عاقل ومفرد. دائما بترجع لها. A car غير عاقل ومفرد. A student عاقل لكنه مفرد وهون جمع. They تستخدم للعاقل الجمع. بينما student هنا كان singular. مفردة. واحنا قلنا لازم يكون في اتفاق agree in numbers. Plural plural. Plural plural. فممكن نعمل بدل a student تصير students. نضيف لها الاس. Students, so they refers to a student. In this case, this sentence is correct. ماشي؟ Okay. I want also to remember that the words like everybody, في عندنا كلمات مثل everybody, anybody, anyone, each, neither, nobody, someone, a person, هذه كلها تعامل معاملة المفرد. Singular, مفرد. فلذلك الضمير اللي لازم يرجع لها, the pronouns that should be referring to, should be also singular. For example, everybody ought to do his or her best. لاحظوا هذه الضمائر اللي عندنا his or her. ما قال there لأنه there غلط. لماذا there is incorrect? Because everybody is singular. فلازم يكون the pronoun أيضا singular. There هون plural. وهذا خطأ. ما يجوز. أيضا في الجملة الثانية. Neither of the girls brought her umbrella. ما قال there. لأنه umbrella is what? ولا واحدة من البنات. واحدة. Neither of the girls ولا واحدة. فهي ترجع للبنات وهي مفردة. Okay. And we're sending pronoun reference number two. Agree in person. Agree in person. For example, if you're writing in the first person I, do not confuse your reader by switching to the second person you, or third person he or she or they or it. Similarly, if you are using the second person, do not switch to first or third. So when a person, for example, comes to a class, this is an example, he or she should have his or her homework ready. لحظة. A person, he or she, and his and her. ما بصير هون أعمل your. خطأ. لازم تكون the pronouns نفس الشيء. The pronouns should agree in person. فإذا استخدمت he or she خلاص بنكتب his and her, his or her, مش their أو your. هذا خطأ. So when a person comes, for example, look at this sentence. When a person comes to class, you should have your homework ready. When a person comes to class, you should. شو لازم نحكي بدل you؟ لازم تكون he or she. You should, he and she should have her or his. لاحظوا her هي ترجع أيضا لشي وhis لهي. Okay. هذه بنسميها possessive pronouns, أدوات الملكية, ضمائر الملكية, مثل this is my pen, this is his pen, this is her pen. Okay. بينما he and she هذه بنسميها subject pronoun, لأنه فقط هي تأتي كفاعل. Okay. It comes as a subject. هذه وظيفتها, functions as a subject. مثلا he goes to the university, she goes to school. Okay. في هذه الجملة he and she are subjects, فواعل. So here's a kind of an example, or actually of exercise. Circle the pronoun that agrees in number with its antecedent in each sentence. The antecedent سوابقها اللي هي nouns. لأن حكينا the pronoun برجع على noun. هذه الجملة الأولى. Each of the girls makes her or their own clothes. أي واحدة حتختار؟ حنختار her. لماذا? Why? Because each of the girls is singular, وhere is singular. Okay? هنا مفرد وهنا مفرد. ما بصير أحكي there. لأنه there, you might think, ممكن أنتوا بتفكر أنه ليش هي girls؟ لازم تكون there لأنها جمع. لا. أنا بتطلع على each of the girls, كل واحدة من البنات. Okay? Number two, the jury finally made its their decision. The jury, اللي هي هيئة المحلفين, هي مفردة. تأخذ their ولا its, لازم تكون its مفرد مثلها. Number three, it often seems that television programs are not concerned with its their viewers. فإما its أو theirs. أول شيء هذه الإيش بترجع هي there, لأنها بترجع للتلفزيون programs, هي النون. لاحظوا إنه كل البرون كل النونز أو antecedent, these are pronouns, the first two are nouns. فالpronouns الضمائر دائما ترجع لإيش للنونز فقط للأسماء. فكل هذه أسماء مش أفعال. Bath. Both Tom and Tony write his their mothers twice a week from Cam. Both Tim and Tony write their. ليش؟ لأن Tom and Tony two people, so it's جمع. إذن أخذنا إحنا أشياء مثل skim scanning. وأخذنا الـ pronoun reference. وهذه I want you to do exercises for that. I will give you some actually exercises in this class. Again, this is another skill of reading, skimming for the topic or main idea. Okay, for the topic and main idea, الفكرة الرئيسية. remember that the topic is just a word or noun or phrase, a few words. It's not a sentence. لما أحكي لك, for example, if you read an essay, مقال عن smoking, the disadvantages of smoking. So what is the topic? ما هو الموضوع؟ منحكي the disadvantages of smoking. بينما the main idea is a sentence or two and can be found at the beginning, middle or end of a paragraph. Okay. والفكرة الرئيسية تختلف عن الموضوع. الفكرة الرئيسية might be found at the beginning of the introduction paragraph. Okay. For example, this is one example to find to skim for the topic and to skim for the main idea. First of all, the topic of the paragraph is where can we find the topic of the paragraph? You just read the first sentence. Do you have a favorite season? Okay, so it's talking about what? Seasons. Okay, it's talking about seasons. مثل الوينتر والفول والسبرينج والادفانتجز. فهي بتحكي عن seasons. Okay, and what is the main idea? What is the main idea of the paragraph? The main idea of this paragraph is summer is my favorite season because it offers the tranquility of the beach as well as the exhilaration of outdoor sports. فلاحظوا الآن, in the third sentence, we have the third sentence, right? So here, in the third sentence, we have the main idea, الفكرة الرئيسية. So الموضوع بشكل عام وجدناه في السطر الأول أو في الجملة الأولى والثانية أو الجملة الأولى اللي هي كانت تحكي عن seasons اللي هي الفصول مثل الوينتر اللي هي الشتاء, الفول الثلج, والسبرينغ هو الربيع, الفول هو الخريف, والسمر تايم هو الصيف. Okay, in here, I want you to read the following essay, then answer the questions that follow. So let us read it together. My name is Elena Changes. I'm from Mexico, but I live in California. I'm students here in English language classes at a small college. I live in an apartment building. It is in the corner of Olive Street and Sycamore Avenue. My address is 2201 Olive Street. There is a big olive tree in front of the building. There is a park across the street. There are a lot of oak trees in the park. The trees are beautiful in the summer. A lot of my daughter neighbors are from different countries. A lot of my neighbors are from different countries. The people next to me are from Indonesia. The family across from the Indonesian family is from Colombia. The stores in this neighborhood are always busy. There is a Korean drugstore and an Armenian flower shop. There are three restaurants in Olive Street, one Mexican, one Japanese, and one Moroccan, Italian, American. I like my neighborhood, but I ask myself one question. Where are the Americans? Okay? So now let us answer the following questions. If you read here, where is Elena from? Where is Elena from? This is our first question. If we go back, you can find this answer. Where is Elena from? She said, I am from Mexico. So this is number one. I am from Mexico. So she is from Mexico. Okay. Why does she live now in California? Let's go back. But now I live in California. I am a student here. So, why she lives there? Because she is a student. Even she is a student. What kind of trees are in California? Mention two kinds. If you go back, what kind of trees we have? She said, there are a lot of oak trees and olive trees. اللي هو الصنوبر والزيتون. So, she has olive and oak trees. Now, when are the trees are beautiful? متى بيكون هذه الأشجار جميلات؟ We go back, the trees are beautiful in the summer. So, in the summer. لاحظوا, in each question, we have some key words. أنا ما عرفت الإجابة إلا لما أقرأ السؤال جيداً. Because the question, once you read the question carefully, it means you've actually known half of the answer. نصف الإجابة. فكلمة beautiful, tree beautiful, لما رجعت على القطعة وجدت كلمة beautiful مثلها. فوجدت إنه, yeah, this is a sentence. The trees are beautiful in the summer. Which country are the people who live next to Elena from? What does a Korean store sell? Who is from Colombia? How many restaurants are there in Olive Street? What is in the front of the building? Where does Elena go if she wants to buy flowers? The rest of these questions, I want each one of you to answer the rest of the questions, 60 questions. I've helped you in 4. I want you to think and answer. Well, right here, the underlined, here we have a pronoun reference, and the underlined word here, if you go back to line 2, this is line 1, line 2, here refers to what? Here refers to, here is a place name, صح? هنا. It means California, where she live. Okay. أيضا, the underlined word 1 refers to هذا هو underline the line number 11. 1. One Mexican, one Japanese, and one Moroccan, Italian, American. So one receiver here, and here. And here, كل هذول بيرجع لماذا؟ للرستورانتس. Mexican one, one Mexican, one Japanese, one Moroccan. واحد Japanese, واحد Mexican, واحد ياباني, واحد مغربي. One هنا واحد معناها المطعم. Okay. Okay, I will leave this one for you. You answer it. And number 4, a word in the passage which has the same meaning as shops. He stores the same thing. A word in the passage which has the same meaning as a flat. Can't apartment. هذه معاني كلمات الموجودة في القطعة. كانت stores وapartments معانيها shops and flat أيضا كان في عندنا road. شو معنى road؟ You should go back to the passage and find out a word just like the word, the meaning of this word. Okay, I will leave all of these to you now. Okay? A word in the passage which has the opposite meaning of behind. شو يعني opposite؟ نقيض. Same معناته مشابه. أما opposite نقيض. مثل شو نقيض black؟ White. Behind هذا خلناه كلمة المحاضرة اللي فاتت. Behind عكسها in front of. في المقدمة، في الخلف وفي المقدمة. أيضا the simple past form of the verb I am. شو هو ما the I am was. لكن the simple past form of the verb are هذه ترجع فكروا فيها. Okay, here we have kind of a revising the structure last class. أخذنا بعض القواعد عن verb to be. سلمى and Fatima from Riyadh. أول شيء بدي أعرف إنه هذه لازم تختار واحدة من verb to be. Okay. This sentence needs a verb. بدها فعل. لأنه ما فيها فعل. Is فعل, was فعل, has فعل, are فعل. Is ما بزبط لأنه سلمى and فاطمة جمع. Was هي مفرد وسلمى and فاطمة هي جمع. Has هي مفرد وجمعها have. فسلمى and فاطمة جمع. بينما are هي الجمع فبتكون الإجابة are. في هذا الكويشن your car and you. As I've told you, the question should start with verb to be. واحد من verb to be. Are your car and you? Car مفرد. فار ما بتزبط معها. Is your car and you? إذن الإجابة هي is. Aren't أيضا هي جمع. وhas your car and you is incorrect. The question should start with verb to be. Okay? Verb to be. اللي هو is or are. London, a country, it is a city. London طبعا هي بلد. London is a country. لا هي صح is قواعديا لكن المعنى خطأ لأنه هي لو وضعنا is لكانت London is a country. لكن لندن هي مدينة is a city مش بلد فلذلك نعمل X. Aren't لا يجوز because London is مفرد وaren't هي جمع بينما London is not a country it is a city. Okay. Ant is insect. Ant أخذنا أيضا أشياء عن الـ articles اللي تستخدم مع singular nouns. Okay, and to start with vowels. حكينا إنه the words start with vowels should take an. لازم تأخذ an. Okay. فهذه الجملة وهذه الجملة واحدة منهم هي الجواب الصحيحة. An is insect. أيضا الجملة الثانية الكلمة الثانية start with vowels وحكينا إنه ال vowels هي ال A وال A وال O وال I وال U. فإثنتين these two words start with vowels so it should be this one. B is incorrect لأنه هذه فيها A وما تزبط مع insect. Are you a doctor? No, I am not. لاحظوا هنا السبيلينج خطأ في كل هذه لكل سبيلينج تهجئتها خاطئة. It should be I am not like this. لاحظوا الشكل أيضا شكل الكلمة. Where is the water? Inside the refrigerator. Water هي مفردة بحكي وين الماء شو لازم أحكي والواتر هي غير عاقل مش بشر فما بقدر أحكي they are for two reasons لسببين. They are لازم أول شيء they هي ترجع لعاقل ثانيا هي ترجع لجمع والwater هي مفرد. Okay. It inside the refrigerator. لو حطيت it أنا If we put it in the blank, the answer is incorrect. ليش خاطئة؟ لأنه it ما فيها معها is. ما فيها فعل. وكل جملة في الإنجليزية سواء كانت ثلاث كلمات ولا أربعة لازم يكون فيها verb to be اللي هو is. Okay. So the answer it is. It is. He is خاطئة لأنه he ترجع للعاقل والwater غير عاقل. And I will leave number 7 and number 8 to you. You do it at home, okay? سهلين. هذه مراجعة للأشياء اللي أخذناها في المحاضرة اللي فاتت. اللي verb to be والcontraction وغيرها. في بعض الكلمات هون fill in the blank fill in each blank with a word from the inbox. وبدي إياكم تحفظوا هذه الكلمات لأنها ممكن تيجي في الامتحان. This store is always crowded. Crowded. Crowded معناها ضاج في الناس. There are always a lot and lots of people. My are from Mexico. My neighbors. So here is number 2. Here's number 1. Neighbors, جيران. My neighbors are from Mexico. They are very nice people. لطفاء. There are 2 big trees in front of my house. فبنحكي front of في المقدمة. هذه أيضا من حروف الجر اللي أخذناها المرة السابقة. There is a big apartment building on the corner of the street. Big apartment, apartment معناها شقة, building عمارة, on the corner of the street. Number 5. People in my neighborhood are from different countries. Okay? Different, من بلدان مختلفة. The drug store اللي هو بيكون مكان بيع الأدوية. فplease, you need to memorize and these words and you should use them. بدي تحفظوهم لأنه ممكن في الامتحان يأتوا بهذا السياق. Fill in the blank each blank space with the opposite meaning. Opposite meaning شو معناها؟ النقيض. Large معناها كبير. شو نقيضها؟ Small. Hate معناها يكره. شو نقيضها؟ Love. Dirty معناها وسخ. شو نقيضها؟ clean. safe معناها امان. شو نقيضها؟ dangerous خطر. expensive معناها غالي. شو نقيضها؟ cheap. married means متزوج. شو نقيضها؟ single. Hungry معناها جائع. شو نقيضها؟ You should know the rest of these sentences. Okay, you can use the dictionary to know the meanings of these 4 words. Okay, أنا أعرف. أنا I've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. وأنت you should do 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, that's fair. هذا عدل. Okay, for the last section we have writing. We got something called jumbled sentences. Okay, rewrite the words in the correct order to make meaningful sentences. Jumbled sentences اللي هي الكلمات المبعثرة. يعني بيكون مش it's not grammatical. Okay, so you have to rewrite them. إعادة كتابتهم. In a correct way to make a meaningful sentence. For example, weather very in Saudi Arabia, hot in the summer is. Okay, so here we start. The weather in Saudi Arabia is very hot in the summer. Fiandana, speak at this English university lecture. So how you should rewrite this sentence? We have a jumbled sentence right here. We need to rewrite the words in a correct order to make it meaningful. So you have to do all of these exercises by yourself. Just as I did in the first example, I want you to do number 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, right here, for example, you can say the color of the book is red. So I did it twice now. I will leave the rest for you. Thank you so much for listening, and I will see you next time. Please do all of the homeworks again and again, and try to do it by yourself. Thank you so much. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.